Now let us explore these colors in some detail. We shall use for our illustrations passages from the orchestral suite from my opera Marymount, since this suite makes extensive use of all of these different colors. Let's start with the woodwinds. Here are the flutes, toward the top of the pitch spectrum of the wind group, the most agile and graceful instruments of the orchestra. In the beginning of the Maypole dances, I wanted to use some simple, graceful decoration, so the natural instrument seemed to be the two flutes. And in the children's dance, we use them for their bright, gay, rhythmic effect. The piccolo, as its Italian name implies, is of course a small flute. If, for example, the decorative passage played a moment ago by the two flutes were played on the piccolo, it would sound like this. And in the Maypole dances, the piccolo is used at the very top of its register to give added brilliance. The two flutes and the piccolo together add one of the most brilliant possible colors at the very top of the orchestra. At the end of the Marymount Overture, the two flutes and piccolo together are used to light up, to illuminate the whole orchestral color. The oboe is a double reed instrument in the center of our pitch spectrum. It is usually described as having an oriental type of sound. Here is the folk dance tune in the Maypole dances as it sounds played on the oboe. The alto oboe, called an English horn for some curious reason, since it is neither a horn nor English, has the same type of color, but deeper and even more somber. Here is a short passage from the love duet. And the two oboes and English horn together give the composer one of the most exotic colors of his entire spectrum. Here is the little theme of the children's dance in two oboes and English horn. The third member of the double reed family is the bassoon, which we might, I suppose, describe as a bass oboe. Here is the same folk dance tune previously played by the piccolo, now played by the bassoon. The bassoon frequently plays comedy parts in the orchestra, so that when in the children's dance I wanted to picture a little boy running and obviously very much out of breath, the two bassoons were given the assignment. The contrabassoon might be called the double bass of the oboe family. It is at the very bottom of the pitch spectrum, sounding like this. When we put the two bassoons and contrabassoon together, we produce this rather lugubrious sound. Last but not least, the clarinet, a single reed instrument and one of the important solo instruments of the orchestra. In the Maypole dances, I tossed the little dance tune back and forth among almost all of the instruments of the orchestra, and this is how it sounds in the clarinet. The name of the bass clarinet explains itself. It occupies approximately the same part of the pitch range as the bassoon. Here it is in a short melodic passage from the Love Duet. But in the lower part of its register, it has an almost sinister sound. The two clarinets and the bass clarinet together make one of the most wonderfully effective rhythmic and harmonic backgrounds in the orchestra. Here is a passage at the end of the Love Duet where I've used the entire woodwind section as a splash of dramatic color.